Introduction. In this chapter, the degradation of the battery is developed. The main consequence is the loss of energy storage, which is very important because it establishes the autonomy of the vehicle and can condition the provision of the service due to not having the required autonomy requiring change for a new battery or the acquisition of a new vehicle with the high cost that entails. Index. Consequences of battery degradation. Symptoms of degradation. Formation of dendrites. Reason for degradation. Factors of battery degradation. Degradation at rest. Tips for good parking. Real cases Tesla. Real cases recurrent auto study. Tips to extend battery life. Subscribe to the fleet management channel. Your subscription is a great support to continue making new videos. Subscribe. 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 Consequences of battery degradation. The battery degrades for different reasons. The main consequences for a fleet are the following. Service provision. The vehicle is purchased with the battery capacity necessary to obtain the autonomy required to provide the service. There are various vehicle models with different battery capacities on the market, and the same vehicle model can be purchased with different battery capacities. The more battery capacity for the same model, the higher the price. When the battery degrades, it loses capacity and autonomy, and over time, it may not have the autonomy required to provide the service. In a fleet, the required autonomy is to provide the service on the same day or to carry out a route without having to recharge the battery when the service is being provided. In a fleet, it is advisable to recharge the battery outside of service hours at our facilities with the slowest and most economical recharge possible. Loss of productivity. Since it does not have the necessary autonomy to provide the service on the same day or route, one solution is to recharge the battery when the service is being provided. Recharging can be done at an external charging point with a quick recharge to take as little time as possible, with the risk that the charging point is being used by a third party or does not work. In addition, the recharge time of the battery must be added. Battery and travel to the charging point. When recharging at an external charging point, the cost of recharging is much higher than if we do it at our facilities. Recharging can be done at our facilities with travel time to our facilities. Furthermore, it is advisable in this case to use fast charging to take as little time as possible, but with greater degradation for the battery and higher cost of recharging. The main consequence is that the time the vehicle is available to provide the service is less, or that more time is needed to provide the same service, decreasing productivity, and the cost increases. Increase in the number of vehicles. It may happen that if we have several vehicles with autonomy below that required, more vehicles are needed to provide the service on the same day, as occurs in last mile distribution. Higher costs. As the vehicle does not have the required autonomy, the battery can be changed at the high cost that it entails, or directly purchase a new vehicle if the vehicle is owned. If the battery is not changed, costs also increase as developed in the previous points. Lower residual value of the vehicle. If the battery is not changed, the residual value of the vehicle decreases because it has less capacity and autonomy than when it was new. If the vehicle is to be sold to a third party, the buyer has to bear the cost of changing the battery in the future. Increased energy consumption impedance. As the battery degrades, its impedance increases and more energy is needed to recharge it and for its operation. Greater risk of fire. Degrading batteries increases the risk of fire and a high probability of loss of the vehicle if this occurs.
Learned about our fleet management consulting and training services. Reduce costs and optimize fleet management activities. We electrify your fleet of vehicles. We carry out the electrification plan until its implementation, known as.
Symptoms of degradation. The symptoms of a battery starting to degrade are the following. Loss of autonomy. The first symptom of battery degradation is that when charged to 100%, they no longer provide as high of a predicted range as when the car was new. Irregular features. In the recharging processes, it could be observed that it takes longer than normal to charge for the same power, or that the process fails prematurely. Irregular recharge. The maximum power of the batteries would last less time than usual, so there would be a loss of performance that would not be related to the motors themselves. Performance loss alerts. The energy management system or BMS monitors parameters such as voltage, temperature, etc. are within acceptable margins. When the parameters go outside these ranges for a certain time, an alert or fault code is issued. Depending on its severity, the driver will be alerted through a warning or will wait for diagnostic equipment to connect. It will not be the same if the problem is punctual or if it has become chronic, and it will be necessary to consider replacing modules or the entire battery pack. Formation of dendrites. One of the main causes of battery degradation is the formation of dendrites. One of the main causes of their formation is explained below, although other reasons are currently being investigated. Dendrites and whiskers are small, rigid tree-shaped structures. They grow inside a lithium battery as needle-shaped projections. When lithium ions move between the electrodes, they have volume changes that allow the formation of dendrites, and that can penetrate the electrolyte, also giving rise to mechanical stress that also has important risks for the health of the battery. These formations can pierce the separator that prevents the electrodes from touching. In addition, unwanted reactions between the electrolyte and lithium also increase, accelerating battery failure. The origin of dendrites in a lithium metal battery lies in a structure known as the solid electrolyte interface SEI. The film where the solid lithium surface of the anode meets the liquid electrolyte. The formation of dendrites begins when lithium ions group on the surface of the anode, forming a first particle. The structure slowly grows as more lithium ions attach to it, increasing in size in the same way a stalagmite grows from the floor of a cave. The energy dynamics on the surface of the SEI push more lithium ions into the column, which grows very slowly until suddenly one of these whiskers shoots out. Currently, research is being done to avoid or reduce the effects of the formation of dendrites in batteries. Research from Massachusetts Institute of Technology, MIT, shows that through the intelligent use of mechanical tension, the formation of dendrites can be controlled. Control is the application of mechanical stress to control the development of dendrites. By applying mechanical tension in a controlled manner, its formation can be directed within the electrode itself, and the electrolyte can be prevented from penetrating, which is the great risk, avoiding the risks of short circuits, overheating and fires. They have not been able to prevent dendrites from forming, but they have reduced their formation, and above all, they have found a way to control the direction in which these dangerous lithium deposits develop within the electrode itself. It is not the first research that has been done in this regard, but it is the first time in which the growth of dendrites has been controlled. And one of the most promising aspects is that this research finds a solution not only for current liquid electrolyte batteries, but also applicable to solid electrolyte batteries. Researchers at the Next Generation Battery Research Center at the Korea Electrotechnology Research Institute developed a porous carbon structure with a hollow core and a small number of carbon nanoparticles gold, with an affinity for lithium within the core, to be used in lithium metal batteries and avoid the formation of dendrites. In the new structure, gold controls the growth direction of lithium by reacting with it, thus inducing lithium deposition inside the core. The results showed that reducing the diffusion length of lithium ion through the pores of the shell and improving the affinity of lithium for gold nanoparticles maintained lithium deposition within the structure, even under loading conditions high current. Reason for degradation. The main reason why electric car batteries degrade is the following. Research from the University of Cambridge has discovered the reason why electric car batteries lose effectiveness throughout their useful life. The research discredits studies published so far on the movement of lithium ions within the battery, which had considered that they are stored uniformly in the individual active particles of the material. This research reveals that its storage is variable and depends on the state of the discharge cycle. The research develops how light interacts with active particles during lithium battery operation. with a nickel-rich cobalt manganese oxide cathode NMC. This technique allowed them to observe differences in lithium storage during the charge and discharge cycle. Researchers discovered that lithium non-uniformity is caused by drastic changes in the diffusion rate of lithium ions at the NMC cathode during the charge and discharge cycle. Specifically, lithium ions slowly diffuse into fully lithiated NMC particles, a process that is significantly improved once some lithium ions are removed from these particles. When the battery is near the end of the discharge cycle, the surfaces of the active particles become saturated with lithium, while their cores have a deficiency of this material. This diffusion of lithium results in the loss of reusable lithium and reduction in capacity. Furthermore, the heterogeneity of lithium observed at the end of the discharge establishes one of the reasons why nickel-rich cathode materials typically lose about 10% of their capacity after the first charge-discharge cycle. Factors of battery degradation. Battery degradation is estimated to be 2% to 3% per year, losing 25%, 30% over the 10-year period, but this is an average, since performance can be improved by applying some safety tips. Battery usage. The main reasons for battery degradation are explained below. Fast charging. High currents cause loss of electrical contact, formation of dendrites, and degradation and breakage of graphite. The result is a loss of active material in the cathode, decreasing the capacity of the battery, and increasing the impedance, increasing energy consumption. Geotab has recently carried out a report that collects data from a total of 6,300 electric vehicles, which has allowed it to determine the average degradation of the packs and the factors that most influence it. Electric car batteries currently tend to lose 2.3% capacity per year. Although the loss is never linear, it is stable during the first 3 or 4 years and accelerates thereafter. Geotab emphasizes that direct current fast charging fully affects the degradation of a battery. Using fast charging more than 3 times a month results in 5 times greater degradation. Thus, without fast charges, a battery loses less than 2% of its capacity in 5 years, compared to more than 10% with regular fast charges. With moderate fast charges, 1 to 3 times a month, the degradation exceeds 8%. Charge-discharge cycles. Like any other rechargeable lithium-ion battery, the more charge-discharge cycles, the more the cells will wear out. A cycle is generally understood as a complete charging process, followed by a discharge process. So, if, for example, a battery is discharged halfway every day and charged again, that would be considered half a cycle, that we would have a cycle every 2 days. The durability of a battery is usually defined in terms of the complete cycles it endures before its capacity drops by a significant percentage, generally to 80% or 70% of the nominal capacity. The cycles of use, charge-discharge, gradually reduce the life of the battery since the liquid lithium solidifies. This chemical reaction eats away at the separator between the anode and cathode, creating dendrites. Electric car batteries have a useful life of about 3,000 charge cycles. Above that number, they can begin to lose capacity more quickly. Durability in cycles is provided by the manufacturer under certain loading and unloading conditions that do not usually occur in practice. So its durability depends on many factors, such as the way in which it has been discharged, and to what extent, the way in which it has been charged, working temperature, and many other factors. High temperature. Batteries do not work properly at high or low temperatures. The optimal operating range is between approximately 15th and 24th degrees Celsius. The high temperature generates a decomposition of the electrolyte, causing the formation of dendrites and a loss of active material in the anode. The result is a loss of battery capacity and increases the impedance, increasing energy consumption. It is very important that the vehicle has liquid cooling of the battery, since the battery in operation is in the appropriate temperature range. In the Geotab study, there are big differences in the loss of autonomy between models that have liquid cooling and those that do not. The Nissan Leaf experiences an average degradation of 11.6% in 3 years, compared to 5.7% for a Tesla Model S. In this case, The poor results of the Nissan are due to the fact that it is one of the few electric cars on the market without cooling in its batteries. One of the models with the least degradation is the Kia Soul EV, with a 2% loss in 30 months because it has liquid cooling. Low temperature. Low temperatures cause the loss of electrical contact, the formation of dendrites, and the degradation and breakage of graphite. The result is a loss of active material in the cathode, decreasing the capacity of the battery and increasing the impedance, increasing energy consumption. Colder temperatures slow the charging rate and temporarily decrease overall range. Charge the battery to 100%. If the battery is charged to its maximum capacity, the exfoliation of graphite and the formation of dendrites occurs. The result is a loss of active material in the anode, reducing the capacity of the battery and increasing the impedance, increasing energy consumption. Download complete. If the battery is completely discharged, there is a loss of electrical contact because the battery is completely discharged, and wear occurs per complete charge cycle, that is, taking the battery from 100% to 0% of energy. The result is a loss of active material in the cathode, decreasing the capacity of the battery and increasing the impedance, increasing energy consumption. Time. The passage of time increases the solid electrolyte interface, causing mechanical degradation with a loss of active material in the anode, decreasing the capacity of the battery. Driving style. Aggressive driving with high acceleration and high speed degrades the battery faster than efficient or gentler driving because it demands more power and current from the battery. Mileage. According to Geotab research, mileage has little effect on the degradation of a battery, as there are no significant differences between vehicles that travel less than 8,000 kilometers per year and those that exceed 25,000 kilometers. Degradation at rest. There is a natural degradation of the battery which then develops.